mighty deeds done in your midst had been done in Tyre and Sidon, they would long ago have repented in sackcloth and ashes. But I tell you, it will be more tolerable for Tyre and Sidon in the day of judgment than for you. As for you, Capernaum, you be exalted to heaven, you will go down to the netherworld. For if the mighty deeds done in your midst had been done in Sodom, it would have remained until this day. But I tell you, it will be more tolerable for the land of Sodom in the day of judgment than for you. The Gospel of the Lord. Just want to share with you that in every sacrament that the church celebrates in the rite, that is the ordering of the prayers that surround the sacrament, in every single one of the seven sacraments, there is a moment, there's often a solemn prayer that comes right before that sacramental moment, where there's a narration of the mighty deeds that God has done. For example, in Mass in particular, we see it in the preface that begins the Eucharistic prayer and falling into the preface. Some aspect of what God has done, perhaps in the lives of the saints, we celebrate today, Last Supper, in baptism, the blessing of the baptismal water, recalls beautiful use of imagery, salvation history leading up to the Paschal mystery. My point, though, is to call to mind that we need to ponder often the mighty deeds of God throughout all of salvation history, which the scriptures and the tradition of the church presents it, but also recognizing that we're part of that very same history. There's something beautiful to think about in our lives as we're called by Jesus Christ, or our interwoven to become part of this great salvation. And what's more, we have to be attentive day by day to what God's doing in our lives, for our sake and for the sake of others. Think of Moses, who we read about near the beginning of the book of Exodus. Certainly wasn't a perfect person. He should have known, of course, that perhaps, in a sense, he was destined for something great in God's plan, not necessarily to be a prince of Egypt, but rather, actually, to be a prophet to lead his own people out of slavery. Moses, of course, wasn't without his faults. We read today about him killing, striking an Egyptian dead, and had some anger in him. And it took time, of course, for God, in a sense, to work on Moses. We don't have any great insight into his psychology, but we do see how in time he's transformed. How God actually does, in fact, make Moses more receptive when he speaks to him, when he entrusts him with his mission. Moses grows again in wisdom, grows in God's grace. That's what's in store for every single one of us in our lives when we call to mind and we recognize not only what God has done in general, but what he's done in our lives. And that's what Jesus again laments of these towns that he spent so much time in, where he healed so many people, where he did so many marvelous deeds, so many mighty works. And so many people, maybe even the majority of these villagers, didn't convert to Jesus, didn't open their hearts to him, quite simply. And that's his mission, is that we would open our hearts to him, that we would be converted toward the Lord. I'll share with you, it's a word I love to use, conversion, to convert. Because it doesn't just mean to change one's path in life just with one single decision, although it can, in a sense, convert to Christianity, convert to Catholicism. But the life of conversion in our spiritual tradition means, first of all, to turn toward, to turn away from the things that really aren't good for us, that aren't part of our lives, that God calls us to, and to turn more and more toward the Lord. That's something that we do every day in Mass, in our prayer. And as we do that, it's linked very much with this idea of recognizing God's great deeds. Part of our work is not only to recognize what God has done for us, to increase our trust in him, maybe to discern more clearly what his calling is, what our vocation is, but a big part of what we're called to do have a relationship where we can speak openly of being really reconciled to God, coming through some difficulty, some sinning, the sacrament of confession, all sorts of things in between. We can tell of these things. It actually helps to bring Christ to others, to give them that same opportunity to recognize how he's at work